It's time to put on our thinking caps and interpret the significance of what we've been exploring. Unless it explains, history is trivial. Did you discover anything unexpected this week that needs to be explained? In your explorations of ancient Greek science, you encountered many different, sometimes contradictory explanations. Interpretations of the significance of Aristotle, Plato, and the Pythagoreans have varied immensely over time and continue to be disputed even today. Consider first Aristotle, who stands at the beginning of the many long conversations that make up most of Western science. David Lindbergh contends, quote, "Aristotle prevailed through persuasion, not coercion," end quote. Would you agree? Next, consider Plato, Aristotle's teacher. To study physics, according to Aristotle, you don't need mathematics nearly as much as observations and common sense. Yet for Plato, mathematics is the language of nature. Let's imagine a friend who says, "Plato's Timaeus can be interpreted as the first work of mathematical particle physics." Would you agree? Finally, consider Raphael's painting, The School of Athens, which adorns the ceiling of St. Peter's Basilica in the Vatican. If you were to select, say, five different figures who shaped the history of science from among those depicted in the School of Athens, who would you choose? Your five figures might include Aristotle, Plato, Pythagoras, and two or three others. How did their answers vary to our two questions? What is nature? How is nature known? How did Raphael express their ideas and the historical relationships between them in the composition of the School of Athens? What is the most significant implication of what you have learned this week? What is your interpretation?